Good morning, everybody, ladies and gentlemen. So my name is Dominique Dessy. I'm a pre-sales at Splunk since seven quarters now. Before that, I used to work for a security company called RSA, and during that period, we used to get hacked, which is always interesting to work for a company getting hacked. So certainly security companies, you learn a lot. But since then, I moved to Splunk. But this is not really about me. This is about Splunk. Visibility and the security, what we can do to Splunk your cloud and to have a better security posture. So the main objection, I'm pretty sure that when you want to go to the cloud, the main objection is coming from pesky security people who say, okay, I don't see anything, I'm losing control, I can't touch that firewall anymore, I can't cut that internet link to protect people from getting in. So security is really usually a roadblock. And like Kun mentioned, and we are also convinced that you're probably far more secure in the cloud, provided that you have the discipline, than if you're on premises, because you have the tendency that you save at home, and in cloud you have maybe to think a little bit. So let me talk about these guys. So during the presentation, I'll have that use case, a small use case, a bit of Splunk. And like Kun mentioned, security is also about visibility. Depending on the god of internet, I'll try to show you what I mean by visibility and bringing back visibility to the cloud. But that will apply to these guys. I don't know if you know them, but these guys are, well, they are two things. They are a financial institution and they're also a regulatory body. So they are not exactly early adopters of cloud. But still, they had, like a lot of people, a lot of issues. You might recognize those kind of issues. So they had all data center, hardware, storage, software. They also want to have disaster recovery, security, but the current security stand was not what they would like to do. So they decide to boldly go to a cloud next to them, and that was AWS. And so they did this, they create their own VPCs, they create their workload onto Amazon. And because they wanted to have that security back, they want to have that security, more control, more visibility, they subscribe to our SaaS offering, the Splunk Cloud. So that means that, based on what Kun mentioned, all the information which is available and generated by the AWS environment, you can send that to Splunk, a Splunk Cloud instance on AWS as well, and gather everything, collect everything, have a logical central place to make everything visible, and that's fine. Your cloud is more under control now. But like many other people, they were not a cloud pure player. They still had their on-premises stuff for various reasons, either a legacy application, they couldn't move it, or things they didn't want to move because of some internal regulation or whatever. So they were a little bit in a split system, having a cloud under control and have the on-premises still a bit wonky, having all the symptoms they described later, earlier. So what they did, and what we achieved with them, so we gather all the information and we also put that everything into the cloud instance of Splunk. So now from there on, they have complete visibility, not only on what's going on into the cloud, because mechanisms are there to collect a lot of information, but also everything which was on-premises is also visible from the very same central place. So from a CISO perspective, I'm feeling quite better. I see everything now. I see a lot of more things that I had on-premises, but also into the cloud. So for them, that was quite easy. I don't know if those of you do know what Splunk is, so the next few slides will explain you a little bit and see how it applies to them. So when we speak about Splunk, we are a software company. And what we do, we collect what we call machine data. So CloudTrail is maybe a log file. There are other things collecting log files. But we're basically able to collect a lot of stuff, not only the logs produced by the server, not only the log produced by your security devices, which are also interesting, but anything that a machine might provide, config file, and that will apply also here in the cloud environment, storage logs. We can do a lot of things, use that information into the logical central place, and use that for different use cases. Specifically today, we speak about the security compliance fraud, because this information I related that with the people from IT operations want to know also, based on usually the same kind of logs, what they're doing with that information. So we can reuse and repurpose the data we gather there. Another thing we can do also is that we can have the Splunk, and I mentioned that, working on different versions, either on premises, into your own premises. Let's say you stick to your data center paradigm, physical one. Yeah, you can Splunk your data center. That's actually how we started. We were called the Google of the data center to troubleshoot IT stuff. You can also move, and a lot of people are actually doing this before widely go and boldly go to a public cloud. You can also have it. You can also have it on premises, on your own private cloud. And of course, you have the public cloud. The public cloud version we have here, and thanks to Amazon, is we can guarantee our SaaS offering having 100% level of availability. Thanks to the way they designed the availability zones and architecture, we're able to bring you Splunk with 100% availability. Not 99.999, really 100%. It's really on SLA, so that's interesting. But what we do for the on-premises, we do also for the AWS environment. That means we collect all the information that was mentioned. You saw a lot and probably have much more than I can put it here. But all that information is relevant from security perspective, but also from an IT ops perspective. But on the security perspective, we collect everything into Splunk. We Splunk that. And the blue box you're going to see, and depending on the time I have, the blue box, that's really what I want to show you after these two slides. Really show you what we do based on that raw information and bring back visibility into something which is actionable for you, to means from a security perspective. So that's an app. It's a collection of dashboards we put into Splunk. But that's for the pure player. And in the case of the FINRA people were in a hybrid mode. So they had their legacy system, the legacy security device onto the on-premises. They had all the AWS information. So we can mix and match everything into one single place so we can apply exactly the same use cases. So it's very, very simple. The information comes from everywhere, and it means for a security guy, now I have visibility on everything. And if I have visibility on everything, I feel more safe. The cloud is probably more, and in this case, this cloud is probably very more chatty because it gives a lot of information. You could mention the API login. Everything is logged, and that's perfect for us. Because you can, if you have everything, you can really correlate everything. You can really bring everything back. Not only what's happening in the cloud, what's happening also to the people who want to hack you. Because they're going to try everything, every piece, every single content. So they really want to go there. So having a complete visibility over the on-prem and the cloud certainly will help them. But that's me talking. I try to secret is about visibility. So let's try to demonstrate to show you a little bit of what's going on there. So now, let's see. That's me. I should have it. Okay, so what you're gonna see is really is a live Splunk running onto AWS. It's a demo environment, so security is about, I have my own credential. So I'm entering and I will show you a basic first. How many? Yeah. I still have a basic sometimes. What I will show you here is the kind of information we receive. So this is typical for people having worked with Splunk, they might recognize this. What's interesting to see is that I'm asked Splunk to give me everything you receive from AWS in this case. So these are the logs provided by AWS environment. Everything is there, but not very sexy, not very actionable. So what we did, if you remember, the box I had on top of Splunk is called the AWS app. So we developed an application to make sense out of that. So that means that based on those clouds, we want to bring something which is actionable, which is readable, which is useful. So we start with a very high level information, and there are a lot of information here as well. About what do we have, the config change in this case, where with the most cloud trail activity. This is a very synthetic, very high level screen. And you can look at the storage. It's really more an IT ops kind of thing. Now comes, I think, the most interesting part. So, Kun mentioned, when did you map your network last time? And to give you an idea what we did here, we do not sell large screen, although we should have, because it's there's a lot of information here, and I will try to fit as much as possible here. So what we hear here, it's a synthetic view of your different VDCs, your different instance, what are going there. And yeah, the screen is very small, so sorry for that. But what's interesting also, because we're collecting everything, and you had also about the config change, we can go back in time and see, okay, this is my config, let's see what I did had January 1st. And it seems that my environment was very much simpler. So really, because you're splunking everything, you're keeping everything, you really can pinpoint from an IT operation, but also from security operations, see what's going on there on time to time. Because your security feature had an incident, you want to go back in time and pinpoint the situation at that moment. But that's one way. You could mention, and I will stick to that, about the security groups. So let's look at, and clean up things, the security group stuff. And see how we I will one more time try to because environment can be very, very sorry. Visualization is sometimes difficult. That's live stuff. Okay. I have a lot of stuff here. Now that's not what I wanted to show you. Thank you. No, okay, I will not go there at this moment. The other things I wanted to show you is also to look at the IAM information. If I have to select a few VPCs in order to see a few things. Otherwise, I will not see anything.
Change your date.
I change the date. I'm still January 1st. Absolutely. Absolutely. There was nothing, so there's nothing to see. That's much better. I did the work from January, so people worked a little bit. So these are my... If you want to visualize the information and access, so you have to see the people, the different user, and here you see the relationship with a user to its AM groups, and from the AM groups to the users, but also to the policies. And so really you can pinpoint, you have the logs, you have the relationship, you can build everything, but here you have the complete visual representation of what you have on, in terms of security stuff. So if I still have a few minutes, I will try now that I'm on the right time, try to come back to the security groups. Because I think that's also one of the things which is important, is you define a lot of stuff, and you see, I will put my instance as well here. And I want to see here, in this case, okay, so I have my different instances which are here, so we can look at what's going on really now. You have, of course, the internet gateways and so forth. You have the related security group that applies to those different instances. Let's say I have here, which is visible, one instance here. But what we see also in this diagram have security group which looks like on the outside, and they do not apply to anything else. So why having different or defining stuff which are totally not applied to anything? This open door to problems. So it might be that if you look at, I selected only the running instance. Maybe these applies to the other instance, the stop instance. So let's put everything here. Not only the running, but also the stop and the transition, and see what's going on. If you do not get seasick because everything is moving, You see that I still have here my instance, the running one and the stop one, but I still have orphaned security group. So that would be interesting to look and discuss with the security folks. Why did they bother to define things like that in order to create problems? Because the least is the better, usually in security. So the least you create. So this is just using the logs provided by AWS. But if you have a visual representation, it's more actionable, I think. The last things I want to show you from one of the things we can do, is let's see about what the user are doing. And this is more double report. It's all about the different user we hear and all the time and the different things that get logged by the different users. And I got to pick up that guy. Yeah, Steve. Jobs, which hopefully. Okay. Which apparently is still active, which might be interesting. But also, there are a lot of unauthorized activities going on for that guy over time. And if you really want to go into the details, these are the same logs you saw on the slides, but these are the real, yeah, it might be difficult to read it here, but these are all the logged activities of that guy and happening. So it's really, you have, if you remember, you have the basic stuff, which is sometimes difficult to action about it. Here, you're making sense of it, out of it, based on time, you see what's going on, and you can quickly make action on it. Okay? And that, because of that visibility, it's exactly the same thing you had, but because of that visibility, now you can action, so you're more secure. Because now we have a lot of information coming on, so it's a lot of information we can action on. And ultimately, that's why the FINRA folks choose to go to the cloud and to have a better security posture than they had before. Okay? And that was about it.